Since 2016, most MacBooks do not have a lot of ports and they just contain either 2 or 4 USB-C ports capable of Thunderbolt 3. In the case of the new Macs with Apple Silicon, you would just find 2 USB-C ports and it's quite limiting. And yes, dongles, hubs, and even docks have become a thing now for many people who use these devices regularly. And while there are a plethora of hubs, some being cheap and some being expensive, many cheap hubs can spoil your laptop or even end up costing a lot of money in the longer term. Not just that, many expensive hubs still lack some features that they just should have for their price. And this feature might just eliminate the extra dongles you have for the same purpose, and I'm not talking about the USB-A ports or anything else. Keep watching to know what I'm talking about. Hey guys, this is Sankyo, and if you're new to this channel, you know what to do. Get subscribed and let's get started. So what USB-C hub am I talking about? Well, it's the Ugreen 5-in-1 USB-C hub with HDMI 2.0, and here it is. Now get this off early, if you do need an SD card slot, I'd recommend you to take a look at the version of this same adapter which has an SD card slot, which would be linked below. Let's start with an unboxing, and it's pretty short, we just get the hub and a user manual. We also get a cap for the USB-C cable, which is pretty handy for preventing dust and debris from collecting up on the port. So let's take a look at the ports we get here. We have 3 USB-A ports, and USB-C port for charging on one side, and we have an HDMI port on the bottom. Now, as I said before, if you do need an SD card slot, take a look at the version of the hub which has this slot, and these hubs are pretty inexpensive compared to their competition. Now, you may ask, what's special about this hub? Why have I been hyping up this much for a simple hub? What is its standout feature and why it's worth for its price? This right here, this is an HDMI 2.0 port, and many hubs, including the expensive ones, lack it. Now, what advantage do we really have? And it's something that many people solve by carrying around extra dongles just to do the same thing. This port right here can output 4K at 60Hz and display HDR content at up to 4K without any issues, which is basically rare to find in many USB-C hubs. Usually you would find these in docks, and Apple does sell a version of their dongle with the same capability, but then it's expensive and quite limited compared to other USB-C hubs. Now, to show that this hub works, I would be hooking up this to my TV, which supports 4K as well as HDR. As you can see, I am currently outputting at 4K and at 60Hz, and I do have an option to enable HDR content, and here we are playing HDR videos to prove the point. Now, also to clarify another doubt around other USB-C hubs with HDMI, there are a lot of cheap ones, including what Ugreen sells. There is a USB-C hub which Ugreen sells, which also has a folding cable, which some people might prefer since it protects the cable from being damaged. It's better than having a cable sticking out. Now, I would recommend you to get this hub if you don't care about 4K 60Hz output with HDR. If you do care, continue watching. Now, why does this adapter support 4K at 60Hz when even certain expensive ones cannot do without an additional dongle or using a USB-C monitor? Well, as I stated before, this adapter and also the other one with the SD card slot all have an HDMI 2.0 port. Now, the other hubs you find all have an HDMI 1.4 port, which can only do 4K at 30Hz. And 1080p at 120Hz. Now, if you want to know more about this specific limitation that HDMI 1.4 has, I would recommend you to take a look at Linus Tech Tips video on it, link in the description. Now, this isn't a Mac specific limitation, rather it's more of these hubs themselves not being HDMI 2.0 ready, and just docks being way too powerful to support these ports, as these docks use a power supply to be run. We also have to keep in mind that docks are pretty expensive and are hard to carry around for travel, so a USB-C hub is way more convenient. Keep in mind that newer MacBooks can power displays at up to 6K, so it's definitely not an issue on the Mac side. Now, slowly some hubs are being updated to support like the Anker 8-in-1 adapter, which also is a great option, and it's more than twice the price as the Ugreen hub, and it isn't widely available. And yes, the Macs aren't the issue, it's the hubs which have these limitations. They're slowly being fixed, so yeah, expect to find many cheaper hubs to feature them very soon. Overall, this is a great USB-C hub for its price, and it offers a killer feature that even expensive hubs lack. Some just buy an expensive USB-C hub or a dock to just solve this small issue. That's been it. Thank you for watching. Drop a like, comment down your favorite USB-C hub, and lastly, subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.